Member for Maple Ridge, Pitt Meadows.
Thank you, Honourable Speaker. Under the BC Liberals, Metro Vancouver and Victoria have become two of the toughest places to find quality, affordable childcare. Dr. Rita McCracken is a family doctor, and despite going on a wait list when she was just 12 weeks pregnant, she struggled to find a daycare space. That meant a family doctor delayed going back to work instead of helping the hundreds of thousands of British Columbians who are looking for family doctors. Honourable Speaker, my question is for the Premier. Why does she think that hanging on to her job is more important than letting a new government get to work on affordable childcare for people like Dr. McCracken?
Premier, British Columbia.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Since you wouldn't let me answer the last question, and I'm sure I will get the chance to answer that question when we're out of the legislature, I'd be delighted to answer the member's question this time. Our government has always cared deeply about childcare, recognizing it is so important for, in particular for working parents to be able to ensure that they can go out to work. Women, in many cases, must work, and in many more cases, want to work. And if not women in the household, then men in the household who might otherwise be stay-at-home parents. And so we need to support them in being able to lead that fulfilling life that they choose for themselves, and also to be able to create the income that they need to support their families. In addition to that, it also contributes to economic growth. And that's why in this throne speech, because our economy is growing so strongly now, we have committed not to more spaces, not to a childcare plan that will happen in 10 years, when a 5 or 6 year old today will have his driver's license, to a plan that will mean 60,000 new spaces in the next 4 years. More spaces, shorter wait lists. And we are also committing in this throne speech through the $1 billion commitment that we've made to childcare, which is the biggest ever commitment any government has made over a 4 year period, to make sure that we are extending subsidies to make it more affordable for people. So now families earning up to $100,000 a year will be eligible for subsidies to make sure that their kids, that they can afford to put their kids in childcare, recognizing that in the Lower Mainland in particular, but all over the province, that life feels much more expensive for people today than it did 10, 15, certainly 20 years ago. This is the most bold and ambitious childcare plan in British Columbia's history. It is not going to happen over a long decade with parents waiting for creating long waiting lists and parents waiting for those spaces to be created. It's going to happen now. It's worked into our fiscal plan. We can afford it, and it's an investment in a future generation that's so important for British Columbia.
Member has a supplemental.
Thank you, Honourable Speaker. Honourable Speaker, over the past 16 years, if even family doctors with all of their resources can't find quality, affordable childcare, how do you think it is for their patients? Dr. McCracken knows that so many of our patients can't get back to work after their maternity leave because they can't find childcare. That's bad for children, it's bad for families, it's bad for the economy. Honourable Speaker, why does the Premier refuse to recognize that people like Dr. McCracken don't trust her to solve the childcare problems that she created?
Premier, British Columbia.
Thank you. As the leader of the party that got the most seats in this legislature and got the most votes in the last election, it's my obligation to present a throne speech to this House. And recognizing that this House is divided, I recognizing that British Columbians sent us a message that they would like us to find ways to work together. We presented a throne speech that members across the House can, I hope, find things in that they appeal to them, that they support, and in fact, things like campaign finance reform. Now, we know since then that members in this House are determined to defeat everything that comes before this legislature. Ignore the message that was sent by British Columbians when they said, with a divided result, that they wanted us to find ways to work together collaboratively. The NDP are ignoring that message. The Greens are certainly ignoring that message. But on this side of the House, we have taken heed of that message. And that's why we introduced the throne speech with the changes in it, in like ones I've talked about in areas like childcare, things that we all know are important. If that member cares about childcare and she wants to make this House work, if the members of the Greens want to demonstrate that this House work, I would suggest that we find a way to support the throne speech and make sure that government can get on with the business we've laid out, business that is going to address the concerns of individuals like the member has raised. People are waiting for childcare, not in 10 years, in 4 years, and that's what our plan delivers.
Thank you, Premier.